Philip Tracy takes hats to places they've never been before. It's rather like a science project. And this season, I see an awful lot of astrophysics. Is it a bird or is it a plane? You never know what to expect at a Philip Tracy show.
I'm not quite sure what this represents, actually, but I really like it.
This is a model should be seen and not heard, look.
I think so, definitely.
Philip Tracy is a fashion alchemist. He concocts miraculous creations through mysterious means.
The whole show was based on 50s. But I like concentrating the idea of what people in the 50s, what their imagination did in the 50s. So in the 50s, the world was first introduced to the idea of outer space. So I tried to mix outer space and 50s and their impression of 50s. So that hat that Honor wore is our sort of Roswell woman hat. So it's sort of a 50s version of outer space.
In the past, your hats have been about volume, and this time they were very, very refined. That was all about the smaller spaces.
Well, that's fashion. Fashion changes.
Trying to decipher the creative equation of a Philip Tracy hat is an art in itself. Obscure ideas and incongruous materials make for exciting viewing. But as each and every invention is unveiled, the question is begged, where would you ever wear one?
Well, you know, Philip Tracy, it was a big event, it was a happening, it was fun. The real problem with hats is that in the end, they look like fantasies, they look like amazing creations, and technically many of them were brilliant. They defied gravity the way they fitted to the head. But, you know, we're talking about something that's fantastical in itself. We're not talking about something that women are going to rush out and buy.
This collection, I have to say, it's superb. Last year, the hats were a little bit more impractical, but this year, hats with everything. Church hats, Saturday hats, Sunday hats, Monday hats, Tuesday hats. I love them, absolutely.
Tracy quotes photographer Irving Penn as the main source of inspiration for this collection. To animate the Penn-like images, he enlisted the help of current British fashion favorites. Recently resurrected 70s designer Anthony Price was one.
And Philip's done things with hats that have never been done in history before.
The thing about Philip Tracy is he is in fact a genius, so there is no bounds to genius, so he'll invent and invent and invent till his dying day he'll be making a hat.
In London for Fashion File, I'm Tim Blanks, contributing editor of Toronto Life Fashion Magazine.